स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रयन्ताम्बूमधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नखाः ध्वनेरित्थं गुणीभूतव्यङ्ग्यस्य च समाश्रयात् न काव्यार्थविरामोऽस्ति यदि स्यात् प्रतिभागुणः. वि वर् डूयिङ्ग् हाफ् वे ऐ स्टाप् वित् दिस् कारिका. सो ध्वनेः इत्थं गुणीभूतस्य च समाश्रयात्. सो वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् द आनन्त्यं, काव्यस्य आनन्त्यम् अपूर्वत्वं च. इट् इस् पासिबल् बिकास् आफ् द डिफ्रेण्ट् वेरैटीस् आफ् ध्वनि. And when you include the different varieties of Gunibhuta also, there can be many newer types of areas that have remained untouched till now by many poets, or the way the expression, he's going to show some more of that apurvatvam, whereas like in Avastha Bhedam or Desha Kala Bheda, there can be so many things that can contribute to a beauty or a navatvam. And it all depends on, for the last section, he says, yadi syat pratibhagunaha. That's very important. So pratibha is the pradhanatvam there. So dvanehe itam guni bhutasya cha samashrayat kavyartha viramaha na asti. Kavyarthasya viramaha na asti. There is no stop for the subject matter that a kavya can deal with, or the way it can express things. Yadi syat pratibha gunaha. So the first condition that he lays down is pratibha should be there. If a kavi pratibha is present, there can be anantyam or apurvatvam in the manner that we have said till now. If there is no pratibha nasti chet, then there is nothing to be nutanataya varnaniyam na kimapi asti. Kim varnaniyam asmabihi iti kavihi mauramewa tushnimewa syat. So satsu api puradana kavi prabandheshu, even though there are many olden poetry of ancient people who have written poetry, yadi pratibha gunah syat, if a poet has pratibha, then, so he does not mention tarahi kim, then we have to take is tarahi kavyasya anantyam bhavet purvoktaritya. Tasmin tu asati pratibha gune asati sati. Pratibha gune asati. If that pratibha is absent in a poet, na kinchideva kavehe vastu asti. There is nothing that a poet has to describe. He can just say, everybody has described it before, I don't need to. Now, because of the meaning or the plot, that can give rise to a beauty, right? We may not, bandha chaya api, the avatarika for this is very nice in Dhidhiti, of course in Dvanyaloka, in Lochanam also. I will just take that and read that out a little bit, 1 minute. Nanu, I'm reading out from here. Nanu, mabhut artha apurvatvam. किन्तु उक्तिवैचित्र्यमात्रेणापि नवनवा बन्धच्छाया तु स्यादेव. अर्थ अपूर्वत्वं न स्यात्. अर्थानाम् अपूर्वत्वं, वि मे नाट् हाव् अ यूनिक्नेस् इन् द मीनिङ्ग्, बट् उक्तिवैचित्र्यं, द स्पेशल् यूसेज् आफ् वर्ड्स् एण्ड् द मीनिङ्ग् इन् मे बि अलङ्कार, द डिफ्रेन्स् इन् अलङ्कारास् केन् काण्ट्रिब्यूट् टु अ बन्धच्छाया, अ काव्यशोभा. It can contribute that syateva tathapi na hanihi iti akshepam samadadati. So bandha chaya api, even though there is a beauty to that bandham, to the way the kavyam has been constructed, arthadvaya anurupa sannivesha shabda sannivesha artha pratibhana abhave katham upapadyate. If the arthadvayam means dvani and gunibhutam, if the gvadvani is absent, or if we do not use words, if the bandha chaya, if the kavya shobha does not give importance to the meaning, and there is just a vakya jalam, then how can it be if there is no artha pratibha abhave, pratibhana abhave, if you don't have dvani or guni bhutam, and if there is only chitra kavyam, then there is no use. It's very close to what Sahitya Darpanakara says, in the sense, see, Sahitya Darpanam, he only accepts Dvani and Gunibhutam. He does not accept Avara Kavyam like Mammata. Mamada says that there is something called Avarakavyam or Adhamakavyam. There is, it is Shabda Chitram and Vachya Chitram or Artha Chitram. But Sahitya Darpanakara says there is Chitra Kavyam, but you cannot name it as Kavyam at all because it will not be accepted by Sahridaya. Here also he says Sahridayanam Nediyaha Na Idam. Nediyaha Samipam Sahridayanam Hridaya Samipam Nasti Evam Chitra Kavyam. So even if the Arthanam Anantyam Api, if it is not there, Arthanam Apurvatvam is not there, there is an Ukti Vaichitriyam. There can be a beauty in the way he has said. Even there, if it is not touched by Dvani or Guni Bhutam, then there is no use. How can we even call it a Bandha Chaya? How can we say that there is a beauty in that Kavyam? Okay, so Bandha Chaya Api, if that also rests on the fact that Arthadvaya Anurupa Sannivesha. It rests on the fact that there are words which have been used to bring out Dvani or Gunibhuta Vyangya. Arthadvaya Anukula. Arthadvaya ityukte Dvanihi Gunibhuta Vyangyam iti Ubayoho Arthayoho Anukulataya E Shabdaha Sannivesitaha. तेषां सन्निवेशेन एव बन्धच्छाया अपि वर्तते तादृश अर्थप्रतिभान अभावे कथं बन्धच्छाया उपपद्यते दि अन्वयम् ऑफ दट सेंटेंस इज अ लिटिल बिट कंफ्यूजिंग सो दट बन्धच्छाया द ब्यूटी ऑफ द पोएट्री इज ऑल्सो नॉट पॉसिबल इफ यू डू नॉट हैव द मीनिंग कन्वेइंग ध्वनि और गुणीभूतम कथम उपपद्यते नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट वन इज ननु Tad vyangya dvaya abhave api. Even though the every shloka in a poetry, in a kavyam, in a mahakavyam, we cannot have dvani or gunibhuta vyangyam. There can be a beautiful use of alankara. Shabda chitram bhavet. Right? Shabda charima sampada eva prabandasya charutvam syat. Iti ashankya, iti shankayam. The next line is an answer for that. So there can be a Shabda Chitram also. Everything need not be Uttama Kavyam or a Madhyama Kavyam. We can have an Avara Kavyam. Then he answers, Anapekshita Artha Vishesha Akshara Rachana Eva Bandachaya Iti Chet Na Idam Na Nediyaha Sahridayana. If Akshara Rachana, words are just connected. The example in Kavya Prakasham is Swachandochala Dacha Kacha Kuhara Chateta Rambuchata Chata. So that entire shlokam, if you say there is a Shabda Rachana, Aksharanam Rachana Kriyate, Nadu Padanam Rakshana Rachana Atra. It's not connected with words. Some he has just used Aksharas there. Anapekshita Artha Vishesham. What is the meaning that is being conveyed? Vachyartham is good. Okay, there is. He's talking about some frog holes on the theorem of on Ganga theorem. So there are frog potholes in the Ganga theorem. What is the, how is that going to contribute to Vaha Mandatam Vidyat? That doesn't even connect with any beautiful meaning or give us a beautiful Vyangyartham there. It is just a clever usage of words and alliteration. Anuprasa. So anapekshita artha vishesha, the meaning is not at all given importance to. Iti aksharasya eva kevalam rachana bhavati tatra bandachhaya bhavet prayaha yadi shanka evam vartate tadrisha shabda chitram api sahridayanam nediyaha na. Nediyaha means samipam, it is not close. Na एवं सति एवं हि सति अर्थ अनपेक्ष चतुर मधुर वचन रचनायामपि काव्यव्यपदेशः प्रवर्तेत देन वी हैव टू कॉल इवन दीज एज काव्यम विच वन वेर अर्थ अनपेक्ष देर इज नो कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑन द मीनिंग देर इज नो विदाउट एनी अटैचमेंट टू मीनिंग चतुर क्लेवर वर्ड्स आर बीइंग कनेक्टेड टुगेदर मधुर वचन ब्यूटिफुल वर्ड्स I don't want to give the example of Lalita Lavanga Lata Parishilana. There is a beautiful meaning also to it, even though there is a Madhura Vachana and Akshara Rachana also is there. There is a beautiful meaning of Uddipana Vibhavam in those words also. Artha, but if it is Artha Anapeksham, like that Swachandochalat, keep that in mind. Kavya Vyapadeshaha Pravarteta. We may have to call even those things as Kavyam. From the looks of this, even in the entire text, he doesn't describe Shabdachitram at all. So probably Dvanyalokakara's standpoint is, if it is not appealing to the Sahrudaya, why would it even be called as a Kavyam? So Arthachitram and Shabdachitram need not be called as Kavyam at all. He only talks about Shabdachitram here, not Arthachitram, so be clear about it. Shabdarthayoho Sahityena Kavyatve. Only Shabda and Artha together. Sahitasya Bhavaha Sahityam. Kayoho Sahitam. Shabdarthayoho Sahityena Eva. Kavyatvam Vyapadeshaha Iti Chet. Katham Tatha Vide Kavye. Shabda Charutvamatra Yuktasya Kavyasya. Katham Kavya Vyavastha Iti Chet. How do we call those as Kavyam? Right? How is it called? Why is it called poetry? If Shabda and Artha have to be together in a Kavyam, then if only Shabdasya Eva Charutvam Asti, Tarhi Katham Tasya Kavya Vyavastha Atava Kavyatva Vyapadeshaha. Why do we call it a Kavyam? Because Para Upanibaddartha Virachane Yatha Tat Kavyatva Vyavaharaha Tatha Tatha Vidanam Kavya Sandarbhanam. Para Upanibaddha Artha Virachane. Someone who has copied another person. Para Upanibaddham Anya Kavinam Kavyam. You take that Artham Virachane. You use the same Artham and make your own poetry here. You are writing a Kavyam which follows the meaning that is there. If I write another Megha Sandesham, how would it be? So para upanibaddha artha virachane. You're using the same meaning that another person has used, and you are writing a Kavyam. And even those paran upanibaddhe api kavya vyavaharaha vartate. We say that this is also a Kavyam. Tatha, in the same manner, tatha vidanam, shabda chitranam api, kavya sandarbhanam. So we use kavyam, we use the word kavyam even for those which are shabda chitram. So in this paragraph, for this karika, there are three points that are highlighted. So one is, kavis, there should be creativity for the poet. Only then can we have kavyasya anantyam. If creativity is not there, then a poet has nothing to describe. Varnaniyam vastu eva na vidyate katehe. Should we always have creativity? Should there always be arthanam apurvatvam? Not necessary. You know, shabda sanni. If there can be a beauty in the poetry, bandha chaya bhavet. How? If it has dvani and guni bhuta vyangya. In some way or the other. But if there is no beauty, artha pratibhana abhave, if such dvani or guni bhutam is absent, then there is no the uniqueness to that kavyam. Now there can be a shabda chitram which another person has not used. If that shabda chitram alone cannot provide a sahrudaya ahladaha, sahrudaya, men of taste or cannot people of connoisseurs cannot appreciate such poetry which has only shabda chitram. You can only, how do I say that? You can marvel at the greatness of a poet. You can marvel at his vocabulary. But you are not going to feel one with that, and you're not going to appreciate, and that rasa anubhuti, if it is absent, then it cannot be called as Kavyam. Why is it called Kavyam? Many people who copy another person also are called, they call it as Kavyam. Right? Any movie which has been first taken in Malayalam has then been translated into Tamil, and then without any new addition to it, it is just a dubbing movie. It is like that, but that is also called a movie, and it is shown in theaters and people go for it and see it. Something, there is just a vishesham, in the sense there is a different language at least. Here in the same language, you are using the same some poet's words and you are just writing it. There is no newness to it. नेक्स्ट् इस् अवस्थाविशेषैः अपि काव्यार्थस्य आनन्त्यं न च अर्थ आनन्त्यं व्यङ्ग्यार्थ अपेक्षया एव. अर्थं डस् नाट् नेसेसरिलि मीन् ओन्ली व्यङ्ग्यार्थ, इट् केन् आल्सो बि द वाच्यार्थम् आर् एनी प्रतीयमानं विच् मे नाट् बि द व्यङ्ग्यार्थम्. सि प्रतीयमानम् इन् द सेन्स् ऐ केन् अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् वाट् इस् हेपनिङ्ग् फ्रम् द प्रकरणं केन् बि डिफ्रेण्ट्. The avastha, the desha, kalam, all these can also contribute to a newness and anantyam. Artha anantyam vyangyartha apekshaya eva iti na. Artha anantyam, the infinite number of, you know, infinite kavyam, right? So anantyam need not necessarily depend on vyangyartha. It can depend on the vachyartha also. Yavat vachyartha apekshaya api iti pratipadayitum uchyate. The next karika is to show that the vachyartha also can contribute to anantyam. Avastha deshakaladi visheshairapi jayate anantyameva vachyasya shuddhasyapi swabhavatah. अवस्था देश काल आदिपदेन स्वालक्षण्य वेदात् विशेषैः आनन्त्यं जायते. वाच्यस्य विशेषैः, वाच्यस्य शुद्धस्यापि स्वभावतः वाच्यस्य अवस्था देशकालादि विशेषैः आनन्त्यं जायते. सो शुद्धस्य, शुद्धस्य मीनिङ्ग् अनपेक्षितव्यङ्ग्यस्यापि. Without expecting the Vyangyartha, Shuddha Vachyartha. We only look at the Vachyartham. Vachyasya Anantyameva Swabhavataha Jayate. Naturally, there will be many differences. We don't need to look at the Dvani or the Vyangyartha uniqueness. Right? In Kavya Prakasham 4th chapter, when he talks about Rasam, and he talks about, he says, Asamlakshi Krama Dvani, Rasadvani, Rasa Bhava Tadabhasa, Bhava Shantir Udayaha and all that. He says it is only one, yet it is Anantam. Even though it is Anantam, it is only one, he will say. What is the Anantyam that he shows? There is an Ayaka Veda, Naika Veda, Uddipana Vibhava Veda, the Deshakala Vedam. He will show so many different classifications of that Samlakshikramadvani, but yet he will say that it is only one, because it is either Rasa, Bhava, Tadabhasa. All of these is just one Rasam that we enjoy. Even though there can be many different avastha, that avastha bhedam is what he says here. The rasadvani may be one. Vyangyartha apekshaya api anantyam darshitam purvam, aduna vachyartha apekshaya api anantyam bhavitum shakyate. So swabhavaha hi ayam vachyanam chetananam achetananam cha yat avastha bhedat desha bhedat kala bhedat Swalakshanya Vedat cha. He puts a full stop to that. This is the greatness of Dunyaloka. You look at Kavya Prakasham. I don't know. I feel like comparing it constantly. I shouldn't be doing that. In the first Udyotam, he will say, Loka Shastra Kavyadi Avekshanat. Loka Avekshanat, Shastra Avekshanat, Kavya Avekshanat, Adi Padena, Itihas Adi. Again, he will put an Adi there. You should stop the list somewhere, right? You can't keep on saying, you know, etc. Men, women, Pakshi, Prani, or you say the classification of animals. You say lion, tiger, etc. Etc. indicates rhinoceros, giraffe, etc. You can't have another etc. You have to put a full stop at some place. He clearly says a full stop here. Adipadam, he doesn't use that Adipadam in the Vritti at all. So, Desha Ve, Avastha Vedat. Avastha is conditions. He will give you that. Situation, Prakaranam. So, situation can be there. That Vedam, there can be a difference based on that. Desham, the place, location, Kalam, time. Swalakshanyam, Swasya Lakshanam. The same person in different avastha can also be there. So swalakshanam means the definition of the same person in different places. That can also happen. Like the same Parvati, I can describe her as being in a forest or doing tapas somewhere else also, or Vishnu as Vishnu himself, as a Matsyavatara, Kurma Avatara, that can also be there. So Swalakshanam Eva, and I can describe the same person based on certain aspects of that person. Taihi cha tatha vyavastitaihi sadbihi. Taihi ityukte avastha desha kaladi visheshaihi taihi tatha vyavastitaihi sadbihi. Prasiddha aneka swabhava anusarana rupaya swabhavoktya api tavat upanibadhyamanaihi swabhavataha api ityukte, you can also say swabhavokti by describing its nature as it is, it in its natural state. Upanibadhyamanaihi niravadihi kavyartha sampadyate. So prasiddha aneka swabhava anusarana rupaya, I can enlist the natural behavior of one person. I can give a long list of the natural behavior of a person, which is very popular. Aneka swabhava. So nayaka gunaha, we saw there were some 8 or 12 nayaka guna. Based on this gunam, I can describe. The best example is Prataparudriyam for this. He has described that one king in so many different aspects. The entire, it's a Yashobhushana Kavyam, right? Alankara Shastram. So one Prataparudra is his character, whom he has placed him in different avastha. His own swarupam, his own swabhava, he has described the same from different perspective, from different angles. So iti niravadihi kavyartha. So imagine if we were to describe Shiva or Vishnu in such a manner. Krishna. Avastha bedat navatvam yatha tadahi. Now he goes to give examples from the kavyam. Bhagavati Parvati Kumarasambhave Sarvopamadravya Samuchayena Ityadivihi Uktibihi Prathamameva Parisamapita Rupa Varnana Api Punaha Bhagavataha Shamboho Lochanagosaramayanti Vasanta Pushpabharanam Vahanti Manmatha Upakarana Bhutena Bhangyantarena Upavarnita Sacha Punaha Nava Udvaha Samaye Prasadhyamana Tam Prangmukhim Tatra Niveshya Tanvim Ityadi Uktibihi Navenaiva Prakarena Nirupita Rupa Saushtava. What better example can you take? Parvati has been described in so many different ways in that 8 Sarga Kavya. When compared to other Kavyams like Naishadham or Bharavis, where it is beyond 15 Sarga, you have a small Mahakavya which is just 8 Sarga, and even inside that he describes Parvati in different places. When he starts in the first Sarga, he says Sarvopamadravya Samuchayena Yatha Pradesham Vinivesitena Sanirmita Vishwasrija Prayatna Ekastha Saundarya Didrakshaya Iva. Vishwasrija Sanirmita Ekastha Saundarya Didrakshaya Iva. As if Brahma wanted to see how it would be if I had placed all the saundarya vastu in one place. Didrakshaya drashtum ichchaya eva ekasmin sthane eva sarva saundarya vastu nam satta drashtum tasya asha vartate eva utreksha. Brahma, it was as if he wanted to see. So sarvopamadravya samuchayena yatha pradesham vinivesitena yatha pradesham yatha ayogyam auchityena, with the full description. This comes at the end. No, he starts describing from her eyes and to her legs, you know, every part he would describe with upamanam. So you'll say upama dravya samuchayena. If I look at the mrigam, it is only the eyes that are I can compare. The rest is not equal to Parvati. So the eyes is very beautiful in a deer. The annam, if you take the annapakshi, the way it walks is beautiful. If you take the kokilam, only its sound is beautiful. In fact, at one point he says, I love that shlokam, Nagendra hastaha tvachi karkashatvat. If I want to compare her thighs to Nagendra hastam, to the gaja trunk, it is too rough for me to compare. So upamana bakhyaha, he says. And then when he ends it, even Kalidasa doesn't know what to do. So sarva upamadravya samuchayena yathapradesham vinimeshitena. Let me take each and every aspect that you find in the standard of comparison, put it in one place, and sa nirmita prayatnat. He took a great effort to create this Parvati. So he wanted to see that all the entire beauty in one place. That is the first. So you feel, so Kalidasa has exhausted everything in the first sarga. Then suddenly in the third sarga, it will come back again. Vasanta pushpa bharanam bahanti. He feels he has not done enough. We may feel, as soon as I finish first sargam, I always feel, you know, he has described everything that has to be described in Parvati. That's it. You know, Kalidasa cannot beat himself. It's impossible. Then he comes, Ashoka nirbhatsita padmaragam, akrishta hemadyuti karnikaram. Beautiful description in third sarga. Because it is Uddipana Vibhava. She has to create that Manmatha Asha in Shiva. So he will give a totally new dimension to the whole thing. Vasanta pushpa abharanam vahanti iva. Vasanta ruto pushpam. So akala vasanta ruto, right? It just suddenly vasanta ruto comes there and people don't know what to do. There is no small stages of a bud and then slowly the flower comes. Nothing of that sort. Suddenly the whole forest is filled with flowers. So she, naturally, a child, a girl who wants to, you know, she is in that yavvanam. She wants to decorate herself and she wears all of the vasanta pushpam as an abharana. Ashoka nirbhatsita padmaragam. Ashoka pushpam, it defeats the padmaraga gems. Akrishta hemadyuti karnikaram. You wear gold jewelry. No, the Karnikara Pushpam is much more beautiful than the Swarna Abharana. Mukta Kalapi Krita Sindhuvaram. Sindhuvara Pushpa is like pearls. She wears those like pearls. And then Vasanta Pushpa Bharanam Vahanti. He again, Punaha Bhagavataha Shamboho Lochana Gocharam Ayanti Esha. This is Parisamapita Rupa Varnana Api. Even though he finishes it in the first sarga, again in the third sarga he brings about, because now Shiva has to look at her. You know, dviti yamaurvi, it's like the moment, you know, when Manmatha sees Shiva, his maurvi is gone. All the bees that are arranged in the form of a string, it completely vanishes away, because Shiva's ugra tapas is like that. But Parvati comes in, as she walks in, his confidence slowly rises. Manmatha feels that he can take her as an upakaranam. So Manmatha upakarana bhutena bhangyantarena upavarnita. She has been beautifully described in another manner, in a more beautiful manner. Bhangyantarena, in a different perspective. In the fifth sarga, totally different from all of this, you will find Sita Kshanam Pukshma Sutadita Dhara Pratamoda Vindava. Her entire Anga description will be as a yogini, how a yogi does tapas. Even there, he would have described her. When Shiva comes in and looks at her and has a conversation as a brahmachari, he comes in the form of a brahmachari and has a conversation with her, there also you will find small aspects of Parvati's description coming about. Anandavardhana does not say that, but only when you read that entire sargam, you will know. Fifth sarga, api kriyartham sulabham samitkusham. So, you know, you should take care of your body first. He will describe that. So through Shiva, Vaktra Nibaddham also he will describe. Not only Kavi Nibaddham, Kavi Nibaddha Vakta will also be used there to give an avatvam for Parvati's description. Where he will point out to the, you know, her lips being without any ragam, without that lipstick or any color, artificial color. It has lost its color. Why? You know, you'll have to take care of your body. So Vaktra Nibaddha description also will come there. Saeva cha punaha. Again, when she is going to get married to Shiva in the sixth or seventh sarga. Ama, seventh la dhaan kalyanam varum. Nava udvaha samaye, when she is going to get married, prasadhyamana, she is being, you know, the ladies are all doing makeup for her. So tam prangmukhim tatra niveshya tanvim kshanam vyalambanta puro nishannaha bhutartha shobha hriyamana netraha prasadhane sannihite vinaryaha tam prangmukhim tatra niveshya tanvim. They seat her prangmukhi, facing the east, because they want to start, you know, doing makeup for her. Prasadhane sannihite abhi naryaha. So all the ladies are all surrounded and they are sitting in front of her. She is also seated. She is ready, waiting to be, you know, attended upon to do the bridal makeup. Tam prangmukhim tatra niveshya tanvim kshanam vyalambanta. They stopped for a moment. They could not even touch her face, it seems. Puro nishannaha, they were sitting in front of her. They were not attending to some other work. They were sitting in front of her. But they, for a moment, they waited. Kshanam vyalambanta. Why? Bhutartha shova hriyamana netraha. Bhutartha shova. There is a natural beauty to her face. Hriyamana netraha. Their eyes were attracted to that beauty that was there in Parvati's face. Prasadane sannihite abhi. They were not waiting for the makeup items to be brought in. Prasadane sannihite abhi. Prasadane sannihite abhi naryaha. Bhutartha shobha hriyamana netraha. Kshanam vyalambanta. They did not want to do anything. They did not want to touch her. This is another new way of looking at Parvati. What a beautiful perspective there. Ityadi uktibihi. प्रतिभासन्ते. Nowhere do you see, when you read the first sargam, you feel it is complete. When you read the third sargam, you don't feel punaruktatvam. He is only describing the same Parvati. The same way, what is the new thing that, you know, people, how many times can you, you know, see the same description of trees and Nayaka, Nayika? First, I've had students who, you know, say, how can I listen to that Shringaram, or how can I listen to Nayika description again and again? It is all the same. It is boring. I've heard students who have said this, but after, you know, a few works, one or two works, even Megha Sandesham for that matter, it is only a Megham description, or the, you know, description of the entire earth. What is the new thing that you can contribute? People have said that to me, but then they have changed their opinion after a few works. I have seen that. So tasya kavehe kalidasasya ekatraiva, in one place, asakrit krutaha. Sakrit is one time, asakrit is many times. Ekatri eva, in one work itself, we don't need to look at Raghuvamsham. See, Raghuvamsham, at least, it has separate stories, right? You have Aja, and then Dasharatha, then there is Rama. So there is no chance of repetition. But in Kumarasambhavam, you're only dealing with one Parvati, one Shiva, and Kailasam. The location is also the same. Now, where is the Bhedam that he has brought in? He has only described Parvati in different, but still, asakrita varnana prakaraha ekatraiva tasya kavehe kritaha api na punaruktatvena bhasante. There is no repetition of anything. A nava nava artha nirbharatvena. Nava nava artha nirbharatvena na asti iti na. It is not that he has not used new. He has always used different expressions, different perspective to give us the same beauty of the same person and in the same work. That's his greatness. Darshitameva chayetat Vishamabana Leelayam. In Vishamabana Leela, he has mentioned this. Na tesham ghatate avadihi, na jate drishyante kathamapi punaruktaha. Ye vibramaha priyanam arthaha va sukavi vaninam. See, Neelakanta Vijay Champu, when he says yaneva arthan mayamalapamaha taireva vinyasa vishesha, there we can probably understand. See, I don't have that pratibha. So I am not able to express it in a new manner. But the same kavi, in the same work, the same sukavi vaninam arthaha avadihi na ghatate, tesham avadihi na ghatate. Or also, you know, when you want to appreciate priyanam vibramaha, your beloved, the different actions that your beloved does. Priyanam vibramaha, ye vibramaha santi, tesham, yatha sukavi vaninam arthaha santi. How many ever times you want to read that poetry, you still feel like reading it because there is no end to it, no limit to it. Vishmapani Leela is a work by Anandavardhana where he says the same idea in a different manner. So ye priyanam vibramaha santi athava ye sukavi vaninam arthaha santi tesham avadihi na ghatate. There is no limit to the actions that a beloved can say. So it is like that shlokam, not a good shlokam, but still shatakritvaha chumpanam sahasrakritvaha something something puna na punaruktatvam asti, right? There is no repetition for that. Very similar to that. So najate drishyante kathamapi punaruktaha iti na drishyante kathamapi, however they may repeat themselves, but there is no repetition in it. There is only a new perspective every time they say something. Ayam aparaha cha avastha bheda prakaraha prakaraha. I think I'll stop with this. Yeah.